Hello everybody. Today we are making the Pioneer Woman's Make Ahead Muffin Melts. This is an excellent breakfast or brunch item. And the most fantastic thing about this is you make up the spread and then you store it in your refrigerator until you're ready to have these little sandwich items. So it's not a whole lot of preparation at the time you need it. So it's great for company, or if you want a nice breakfast, but you don't want to get up early and put all that effort in. So you need 1 pound of bacon, which I have cooking already. That is our first step. You need 2 cups of cheddar cheese. You need English muffins. You need 6 of those. You need 12 hard boiled eggs, which we will peel and chop, 4 Worcestershire sauce, 5 dashes of it. You need 1 cup of mayonnaise, 1/2 teaspoon of garlic powder. Now I have granulated garlic here because I accidentally bought the wrong thing. So I will be adjusting the amount to equal what the amount of garlic powder would. And you also need 1 heaping tablespoon of Dijon mustard. Now I'm going to link the actual recipe on the Pioneer Woman's site in the description of this video below, so you can access that and have the specifics and even print it off. So the very first step is to get your bacon cooking. Now when I'm doing bacon for just a recipe like this, and it doesn't really matter if it's all pretty and straight, I just throw it in a deep pot. We are going to fry this bacon until it's chewy and slightly crisp. So we are not going for well done bacon. When the bacon's done, I'm going to transfer it to a plate with paper towels to absorb some oil, and then we're going to chop it up. Our next step is to peel these hard-boiled eggs and roughly chop them up. Aren't they beautiful? These are from my pretty girls, made me these. So here we have the hard-boiled eggs, coarsely chopped, and the bacon chopped up. I used my kitchen shears to do that. And I'm just going to add the rest of the ingredients to this bowl here, and then we're going to gently fold everything together. So we have 2 cups of cheese, cheddar. That is my 2 cup Pioneer Woman measuring cup. So cool. See? It's a beautiful set. And then we have 1 cup of mayonnaise. You need 1/2 teaspoon of garlic powder. I'm using 1 teaspoon of granulated garlic powder, because I purchased the wrong thing and it's about 1/2 as strong as garlic powder. And then a heaping tablespoon of Dijon mustard. Now this recipe, it kind of reminds you a little bit of egg salad. You've got the hard-boiled eggs, mayonnaise, mustard. Ordinarily, you would put a little salt in your egg salad. But with the addition of the bacon and the saltiness from that, you don't really need salt in this, but you can mix it up. And if you feel like you need some, you can throw some in. If you feel like you need some pepper, you can throw some in. So I'm gonna gently fold this together. Actually, before I can stir this together, I forgot we need to add the 5 shakes of Worcestershire. Oh, I know, shakes. Shakes are a tricky measurement. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And you know, it just doesn't have to be exact. That's
That's basically what it means when a shake is included in a recipe.
We now have everything well combined by carefully folding it together. And I'm going to put the lid on this and pop it in the fridge. I'm not going to serve this until later. When I serve it, what we're going to do is put it on the English muffins and then broil them. And the cheese will melt and this will be a hot item. But until then, it's going in the refrigerator. Now we just need to preheat our oven broiler to low. We need to split the English muffins, put them on a baking tray, and then each half needs a generous scoop of our topping. We're gonna spread it out. And then we're gonna broil on low, on a lower oven rack for 3 to 4 minutes until the cheese is melted and things are nice and warm, but nothing is burnt. So I just took a scoop and scooped a heaping scoop on each one of these. And now I'm just using a little spatula and kind of pressing it down and spreading it out. So I have all of these spread evenly distributed between the 12 English muffin halves and kind of pressed down. So they're all about the same height. Now we're gonna put them in the broiler and we will check them in 4 minutes. Here we have the completed item. You can see the bacon has kind of crisped a little in the broiler. I wound up doing approximately 12 minutes on low. This broiler in this oven, which I've only had a little over a year, is an electric broiler, and it definitely broils differently than my previous gas range. So just watch it, observe it. You want a light browning, a little crisping on the edges. You want the cheese melted, but you do not want any burning. So I hope you enjoy this recipe.